You know, Charles
what happened
did
to the Superman
that's
outfit?
Fine. Well, you know, Superman gets old. Charles did that drawing. I'm a little offended by it because it makes me look overweight. Anyway, despite all of this hemming and hawing over mortgage rates supposedly rocketing, you know what they're rocketing to? Levels that are still, and this is where my fellow old fogey Charles could remind you, they're still ridiculously low and darn near to what this old fogey was paying per day when he and the missus got their first mortgage back in the early 1980s. Okay, not really, but it is time for a little reality. Back then, you know what a 30-year mortgage would cost you? Forget mid-single rates that everyone's kvetching about now. Try, here we go again, we're gonna throttle you. Try high teen rates, try north of 18.5% back in October 1981 when Charles and I were young. And we're complaining about not even 4.5% now to Kendra Todd, who says it's time to get real and still be real grateful. You know, Kendra, of course, you're much, much younger than I, but I mean, people forget that, don't they? I mean, they look at this backup in rates and they say, oh my gosh, you know, 4.5%. Before I know it, it's going to be at 5%. I'm thinking, wow, perspective is everything.
Well, Neil, I am a little younger than you, and I was not old enough to buy a house in the early 80s. But,
dig that ditch even deeper, Kendra. Keep going.
I couldn't help myself.
Right.
But you're right. We need to give some perspective to this. I mean, it is kind of ridiculous. Granted, I do want to give people some credit. I understand that rates have jumped an entire percentage point in the last 3 to 4 months. And if you're out there actively home shopping, it is a, you know, a bit of a sticker shock to see that you now are going to have to pay $100 or $150 more. But let's just play a little game of what will a $1,000 a month mortgage payment get you? Today, it will let you borrow $200,000. 5 years ago, you could only borrow $160,000. So you're able to actually afford to purchase 20% more home today for the same amount of money. Now, just to really rub it in, back in 1983, August, you could only afford to get a loan for $84,000.
Wow. You know, here's where we're, again, too old to the old fogies, Kendra. The turnaround. Back then, a housing boom was just beginning. You could see quick appreciation year in and year out. Your home was your piggy bank. My wife and I, in our case at the time, could successively buy, you know, bigger and bigger homes on the belief that that would continue, and it did. And then, of course, the music stopped about 5-6 years ago. Do you envision the same thing happening now, that everyone's saying, well, housing's off to the races, you know, the rate uptick, a lot of buyers who were sitting on the fence are back in, and then maybe we're repeating all that over again?
Well, it does have that psychological effect of urgency in getting buyers off the fence and say, wait a minute, I need to go shopping now before rates skyrocket even more. But I think the bigger issue is the constriction in inventory. That's what's really causing the panic and the multiple offers on homes and, you know, prices going up so dramatically.
Well, why is the inventory so low? Because you think a lot of homeowners who've been stressed out would put their homes on the market, or is it that there's still many of them underwater and they're not ready to put their homes on the market?
Yeah. Anybody who could sell a house pretty much has. I mean, that's the bottom line. We have 10.5 million homeowners still underwater. However, we've had a good pace of appreciation, around 9% year over year. And if that continues at 5 to 8% over the next year, we're going to have 30% of those underwater homeowners be in a position to be able to refinance. Now, listen, rates are they're so low still. I mean, I am telling my clients to go into a 15-year mortgage. I mean, you can literally pay a couple hundred bucks more to get a 15-year mortgage today versus a couple years ago. So why wouldn't you want to just plunk down the extra couple hundred dollars, be a little more conservative, and own your home in 15 years?
Quickly,
I mean, that's the way to a productive
level,
housing market.
I'm sorry, Kendra. What level would you get a little worried if it's not 4.5% or 5%? At what level would you say, all right, this party at the very least is going to slow down?
Well, I think that it really depends on what happens with the economy. It's kind of a loaded question. I mean, real estate, because interest rates are artificially low and there is no inventory, it has recovered in spite of the economy. But if rates do get up to 5.5-6%, they're going to have a helping hand with some economic growth and job growth.
Very well put. Kendra, always a pleasure. Thank you very much. Kendra Todd in Salt Lake City. Well, talking housing.